All right, in this lesson, we're looking at the Eagles' Take It Easy. I'm going to go through all the guitar parts. I'll show you it all on electric. The chords are obviously the same on the acoustic. Starts off like this. So what I'm playing there is a G, C, and a D chord. I'm playing the G. I'm playing this version where you use your pinky on this string and play that D as well, because you hear those octaves coming through on the G and the D. And you want to leave your pinky there for the other chords too, because when you go to the C, you're going to play the normal C chord, but leave the pinky there. And you're always kind of coming up, so... So when you come up, you got that high G. Then this D chord here, the version of this is interesting. It's you're basically like a D7. You got your fourth string open, your D bass, your A, and then the C, which is like D7. And it's got the high G with it, though. They just leave that G in there, like a D suspended. So it's like a D7 suspended. So we got, after the C, you leave your pinky there and play these two and come up just the same, just down to the D string. So you just want to emphasize kind of the top part of the strings that are always coming up. So they do two of those, and then they're on a G chord, and he does this famous little riff. And it's very typical. We're, you know, from the G chord, we're still playing that D, and we're bending this A up to the B, which is in G chord as well. So it's just some notes out of the G chord there. Hold the D steady and give that a whole step bend. And then down to the open G. And we're just going to walk down after that. Down on the fourth string, the E and the D. And then here it's going to throw a B flat in instead of the, you know, the B right out of the G chord. He throws in like a flat. It's just gives you that blues type sound like that. So he's got. Just like that. Okay, now the chords are interesting. They're, you know, they're your typical G, C, D, and A minor. But if you try to figure out how they go along with the vocals, seems a little tricky. And after listening to it a few times, it dawned on me that this song is kind of like four long verses. And the reason I say that, without a chorus, actually, when they're singing Take It Easy, they're on a certain part of what I'm calling the verse. But then the next time around, they're not singing Take It Easy, so it's not like a chorus. They're singing Come On Baby, Don't Say Maybe instead of Take It Easy. So, but it's the same chords behind it. So the way to remember this long verse that repeats four times is I break it up into three segments. The first part, I'll just go through them here, is G, D, and C, then G, D, C, and G. That's the first time, right when the singing starts in the song. Just like that. That's segment one. Then they get into what I call segment two, which the first time around they're singing Take It Easy. It's an E minor, E minor 7, and a C and a G. And then it's going to finish out with this A minor, walk up to C and G. Or I'm sorry, after the C, they go to the E minor again. So that's the second segment. And then the third and final segment is just C and G a couple times, and then A minor walking up again to C, and then ending on the G. So one time I'll play a full verse for you here, and then check out this chord pattern. This is segment one. Segment two. And then segment three. So that whole thing basically repeats four times. Actually, the third time is the lead solo, and it gets cut a little short. But other than that, and then there's a couple other differences. You know, when they're singing Take It Easy, where they're playing, this is segment two now, E minor and E minor seven, on the where they're doing Take It Easy. Well, in the second verse, when they're singing Come On Baby, Don't Say Maybe, that part is going to be, instead of the E7, they're going to go to the whole D chord instead of just playing that D note. So it's going to be. And then at the end of it, they leave it the same there. And it also does that during the lead solo. But then on the fourth verse, they're back to the Take It Easy. So instead of the D chord, they're just going to play the seventh note. So that's basically how I remember the chords. It might seem a little convoluted to think about it in segments like that, but actually, you know, playing along with it, it wasn't consistent. They make these little changes, and if you remember those three segments and then the differences, then the chord structure becomes clear regardless of what they're singing. So that's the way I do it.